Hey guys, and welcome to the first part of my Alien Shooter playthrough. The votes for the character of Anonymously decided that we're gonna play as the girl. So, we'll do that. Playing a Norma, as I said. When you're just starting out, you can get the flashlight, but yeah. The thing is, it's not very helpful, but 20 bucks isn't gonna make any difference in the long run. Now, I would say something about the plot of the game, but it really doesn't matter, so this game has a plot, you guys, but I can make it simple for you. Here are some aliens. Shoot them. That's unnatural. Anyway, now a big part of your income in this game is gonna be from secrets. You might have noticed I just got a bunch of stuff from behind this wall. The game does a lot of stuff like that. Although broken walls are more likely to result in money. We'll see that a bit later. Now, about the character. I think that the girl is the better choice in this game. Simply due to the fact, here's one of the broken walls. As you can see, the game teaches you about the broken walls in order to get you in. And by the way, here I recommend to always just get the night vision. The shotgun is not worth getting just yet, and you'll find one in a bit. Anyway, the girl is faster, and she has a much better accuracy, while the guy has more health and can carry more ammo. The health doesn't really matter, because as the guy, as the girl, you're not gonna get hit anyway. Or at least that's what you're gonna hope for. If you're in a position to die, then a bit more health probably wouldn't help you. Max ammo, same deal. The best weapons in the game don't require that much ammo anyway. So, yeah. In conclusion, I don't think there's really a reason to get the guy. Here's a broken wall. You might not notice it in the YouTube resolution, but in the screen resolution, it is quite possible to see it. Anyway, as you can see, a shotgun. No real need to waste your money on it. In fact, there are only a couple of weapons I recommend buying over finding in the entire game. Anyway, meet the aliens. I'm shooting them with the shotgun, but there's really no need to. The pistol does just fine. Thing is, I won't really need the shotgun, so I just use the ammo whenever I have it. There's no real need to save up. The only reason I'd maybe like to save up is for the special monsters, but yeah. This is the basic variety of alien. They walk towards you really slowly and try to bite you. You notice that they are green. This isn't a coincidence. See, the enemies in this game are color-coded for your convenience, as the trope goes. Green is the weakest. And, yeah, that was it. Yeah, the first mission is pretty damn short. Which is why, of course, this episode won't just be that one, this mission. The thing about the pistols that makes them so much better than, say, a shotgun is the fact that they have infinite ammo. This is actually really, really good. The shotgun's limited ammo means I save it for slightly more important parts at the start of the game, then don't use it ever again. Pistols I use later in the game. In fact, when I was playing on hard, there was a part where I ran out of ammo. That was my mistake, but I'll tell you about that later. And I just had to use the pistol and kite a bunch of enemies. I actually died on that one eventually. Well, whatever. I just want to get this money. Next mission. Now, purchasing the grenade launcher, not worth it. Purchasing armors, general, not worth it. Purchasing lives, not worth it just yet. The rescue bag and the drone are useful, but right now what I'll do is get an accuracy implant. No reason not to. And accuracy is very important, because accuracy does matter in this game, as opposed to so many other games. You notice that a lot of things explode in this game. I like that. In fact, this stage has a bunch of interestingly placed walls, as in breakable walls. Some of them are just general, like this one, and you have to notice the tiny crack and shoot them. But for others? Well, there's a really nice one in a bit that I'll point out. Anyway, where do I want to go? Oh, yes. A lot of earlier levels have this turning on the power thing. It's a lot less frequent during later levels. In later levels you'll generally have to destroy generators in order to turn off things rather than turn them on in order to turn things on. But for now it's just that. Later levels also have a lot faster action. These levels are just kinda slow at the beginning. I guess they were going for some kind of, I don't know, to make the player stressed out. Anyway, as you can see, there is a rescue bag here, so there's really no need to buy one. In fact, there's almost never any need to buy one. You'll notice that they spell rescue bag. They spell rescue bag as rescue bug. I find that very entertaining as well. Anyway, see this wall? It's a bit cracked. It's the only way into this room. I always thought that was a nice touch. I mean, it's just $100. Is it? Yeah, it is. But it's a nice touch. The game doesn't often put stuff in places where you can't see it like it did in the first level. I kinda like that. Anyway, I know what you're thinking. Alpha, stop blabbering and get on with the alien shooting. Well, yeah, but there's stuff to do. Anyway, alien shooting commencing. This game. Okay. Second variety of enemies, yellow enemies. These are faster. They may be stronger, but I haven't noticed any significant difference between their strength and the normal DNA strength. Not that I would notice. You might have noticed that I just got a speed implant. Those freebies implants are very useful, but not very common. Usually I get left with a couple of them that I can't pick up at the end of the game, because there's a maximum implant limit of 3. The really impressive weapons don't come until much later in the game. Right now we're just running with the kind of generic pistol, shotgun, grenade launcher. Later on we'll go on and get some more interesting weapons. As well as more interesting enemies. Really these first few stages are not challenging on any skill level. Unless you're really bad or whatever. You notice that shooting in the general direction of the enemies, while it walks, is much less efficient than shooting at the enemies. Yeah, I noticed that too. An extra life in the hidden place here. It's nice, but it's not all that needed. Really, I'll be maxed out on lives much before I need my lives. You'll notice that I'm giving a lot of these enemies. That is because, well, they kinda suck. Yeah, I don't even need the shotgun ammo. Which is why I said don't get the shotgun. By the time you need it, you'll have better weapons. Unless you're the guy, I guess. Maybe the guy benefits from the shotgun more. I don't know. I mean, he sucks. By the way, if you're thinking this is a lot of enemies, wait until you see the ambush of level 4. That one's really scary. First scary moment of the game, if you ask me. Unless you count the first attack by the aliens as scary. And then I'm not sure what you wouldn't regard as scary. You notice that there is another treasure in the wall here. You also notice that while the enemies are hurting me, I don't really care. That's because there's an abundance of health drops on the ground around here. There's no real need to care. Oh yeah, you can destroy stuff. How surprising. Explosives can be useful while fighting the enemies, but in general you just shoot out the enemies instead. There are only a couple of areas in the game where explosives are more useful than actually shooting the enemies. Oh, well, not useful. More like... or easier to kill with than the weapons themselves. This game only has a couple of enemy varieties. We've seen one, we'll see the others soon. Additionally, the game color codes enemies. I believe we'll soon see the third variety soon. And I'll point out the fourth when we get to one. Fourth one's really rare. Anyway, that's the grenade launcher. As you can see, there's no real need to buy either the grenade launcher or the shotgun. So, grenade launcher, what does it do? It launches grenades. Oh, there is. Number 4? Yeah, I know we haven't seen number 3 yet, shut up. Number 4, the blue enemies. They have a lot more health, and I'm pretty sure they're more powerful. Anyway, since this is the weakest enemy in the game, it doesn't really matter. You also notice the kind of walking guys. Yeah, that's the second variety of enemies. They aren't very threatening, but they're just the basis for a variety that we'll see in the future. Anyway, that was this part. I could go around and get more money and... More shotgun and grenade launcher ammo, but there's really no need. Anyway, that was really short, wasn't it? I guess I'll do a bit more. We could get the minigun right now. And the minigun is really good. But I think I won't. Instead, we're gonna get... more speed. Moving fast is very important in this game. So yeah, keep that in mind. It's very unlikely that you won't have enough money to max yourself out. In fact, when I was playing on hard, I was able to buy everything on the menu in the final mission and still have some money left over. So yeah, don't worry about your money here. I'm just gonna gather up a few things before starting out the actual fight in this level. Which you notice is quite abundant. Yeah, a very large portion of your money is going to come from, well, inside broken walls. Anyway, even with this many enemies, it is entirely possible and plausible to never get out the shotgun or any launcher on this level. If you're not playing on hard, then hard they might have a little bit too much for you. But they're not really a challenge. They never are. Of course, this part does kind of require a stronger weapon. That door behind me, if you couldn't notice, is locked. But, as you can see, the grenade launcher handles it quite well. This is probably the one part where the flashlight would be just as good as the night vision. This for the first bit of that, because there's really no need to see everything, just what's in front of you. regardless, this game's not hard enough to debate whether spending the 20 bucks on the, flashlight was worth it. It probably wasn't, but I don't like leaving things unbought. Anyway, as for the grenade launcher and the shotgun, don't expect to see them again much up to pretty much the next level. There's just no need to use them, or reason, when you have the Vulcan, which is, oddly enough, a lot better than anything else, until the final run of the game. The rocket launcher is nice, but the Vulcan does its job at least as well, and has a lot more ammo to go with. Now if I were the guy, I would have to give a lot of money to be able to move as fast as I am right now. You may notice that some enemies are slightly darker than their counterparts. Those are the red enemies. They're basically like the yellow enemies, but they're stronger. That's basically all. The enemy colors will be a little bit more important later on, once we get to the enemies who can actually shoot, because then it will control if and how powerful, and if they can shoot projectiles and how powerful these projectiles will be. Mind you, while I have played the first campaign, which is this one, I have not played the second campaign, or the third campaign. Damn, when we're playing this way. So stay tuned for that, because I will be going blind into those. Pretty sure they start you off from scratch. So maybe I'll even have to buy the shotgun. Shock and awe. As you can see, the pistols just take everything. I could use the shotgun and kill everything a bit faster, but there's no need to. I have my dual pistols, I'm not wasting any ammo. Where the hell would I like to use the shotgun? You notice that there is a breakable wall here. Yeah, don't break that. Not yet, anyway. That will make the enemies another way to get into this room, right when they have one. This one. I wonder if that's a blue guy. This one, never know. No, probably red. Yeah, the grenade launcher pretty much outclasses the shotgun in every way. So if I ever need a stronger weapon in this part of the game, I just take out the grenade launcher and do that. It's a bit harder to control than the shotgun, admittedly. But if fired straight at an enemy, and you notice I've maxed out my minigun ammo. Anyway, if fired straight at an enemy, it will explode. No questions asked. So, yeah. That one downside, not really a downside. Oh look, yellow armor. Although obviously you can't see the color, but it said yellow armor, and I think I can toss the game on that. Oh, I really hope I'm not recording the black screen for some reason. That would be sad. It's not like I have all that much time these days. I'm a busy guy. You notice that there is a very weird glitched out soldier person over there. I'm not sure what's the deal with him. Seems to be walking on top of that box. Well, that worked. Oh, you, I don't really care about the ammo of anything, as you've noticed. Best weapons in the game have this quality. The ammo, you have enough to get by anything. Oh yeah, let's go on and break that. What that? You notice that there is some dynamite over there. I haven't mentioned it when I did so in the previous stage, but a lot of times the enemies will spawn out of holes, and you have to kill them and destroy the holes with dynamite. Oh look, I have to switch to the shotgun. Whatever will I do? That's the funny thing, you see I have 5 lives despite not dying a single one. At the worst I'll die, not lose anything. Notice that circle strafing is quite useful. Well, yellow enemies are not all that much more durable than green ones. The extra health is only really noticeable on one kind of enemy. The red ones are very noticeably more durable. Quite annoying, so really. Anyway, yeah, dynamite. It's a useful thing. Plus it makes explosions. How can you say no to explosions? And really? Who in the right mind would say no to an explosion? I know I wouldn't. Oh look, a random guy. I think I'm out of ammo for everything. Let's see how I can how long I can survive with just the pistols. Hint? A long, a very long time. Oh, check that out, he destroyed my armor. I've actually never noticed that animation. Oh, that wall. Well, I'm learning new things now. Good thing those guys started attacking that wall. I've never ever seen it. The more you know. Another wall over there. It's a lot easier to see walls when you have night vision. Breakable walls, there is. And that is why you do not purchase the mega. Well, no need to use it just yet, though. Let's start by wasting all my unneeded ammo. Because I've just now obsoleted almost every single other weapon in the game. Though I guess I'm gonna use it anyway. Oh, well, I was about to say, considering how much ammo there is in the stage for it. But I guess that doesn't matter anymore, does it? In general, the mission is complete once you kill all the enemies in a stage. Simple like that. Pretty sure there's an implant in this room. No. So I don't know about that one. Alright. Well, the next mission is one of the scarier missions in the game. Probably the scariest, I'd say. But we're out of time for today, so I guess I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.